In anticipation of the upcoming Resident Evil remake, over the last couple weeks we've done story recaps for three of the game's most central characters: Jill, Carlos, and of course, Nemesis. But there are a couple other characters in the game who have an important role to play in the story besides those three as well. Perhaps the most central of those is UBCS soldier Nikolai Zinoviev, and here we'll be recapping his entire story from start to finish. Before getting embroiled in the shady dealings of Umbrella, Moscow-born Nikolai was a member of the Soviet Union's army, having been conscripted at a young age. And like many of his compatriots, after the fall of the Soviet Union, he was tapped up and recruited by the Umbrella Corporation. On paper, he was a sergeant in the Umbrella Biohazard Countermeasure Service, or the UBCS. But behind the scenes, Nikolai had other responsibilities as well. Thanks to his close workings and relationship with one of Umbrella's top-ranking soldiers, Sergei Vladimir, from their days together in the Soviet Army, Nikolai also spied on members of Umbrella themselves, as part of a secret internal group called the Monitors. Monitors were usually in the know about even some of Umbrella's most top-secret projects, and were responsible for reporting any suspicious activities by Umbrella employees to their superiors. While not too much is known about Nikolai's work for Umbrella during his earlier years working there, his most significant mission came in September 1998, when a deadly T-virus outbreak ripped Raccoon City apart. Umbrella put all the soldiers of the UBCS on alert, scrambling as they were to do some damage control. They sent scores of their soldiers into the city, and while most of them were under the impression they'd been sent in to rescue civilians, as is always the case with Umbrella, those seemingly noble intentions were just a front for something far more sinister. Among all those UBCS soldiers, Umbrella also made sure to place several monitors in Umbrella while Raccoon City was tearing itself apart, with their primary objective being to record the combat data of zombies and other BOWs to determine how combat ready they were. Nikolai was among this group of monitors, and had been deployed with a few more objectives. One of these was to record data on the Nemesis T-type, and the other was to destroy Raccoon General Hospital, a place that was funded by Umbrella and had been researching possible vaccines for the T-virus, and as such had plenty of incriminating evidence on that organization's activities that needed to be destroyed. Nikolai was told he would receive monetary rewards for each objective he completed, and extra cash on top of that for additional work put in as well. The UBCS's incursions into Raccoon City proved to be ill-fated, predictably enough. Large scores of soldiers were killed very quickly, and Delta Platoon, the squad that Nikolai had been a part of, was quickly whittled down to just three survivors: Nikolai himself, Carlos Oliveira, and Mikhail Victor, with neither of the other two being aware of the true nature of Nikolai's work or his objectives. It wasn't long before the three of them crossed paths with STARS member Jill Valentine. After Carlos and Jill met with each other following a distress call that had been sent out by the former while the latter was in the STARS office in the RPD, Carlos took her to a tram that he and his fellow UBCS survivors had hunkered down in. Nikolai, of course, instantly recognized Jill, and was aware that she was one of the targets that Umbrella had marked for assassination. However, something else Nikolai was aware of was that Umbrella had let Nemesis loose in the city, who was hellbent on tracking down and killing any STARS members he could get his hands on. Concerned that Nemesis might spot Nikolai with Jill and mistake him for one of her allies and thus mark him as another one of his targets, Nikolai decided to leave the group by staging an explosion and faking his own death. He did, of course, eventually cross paths with both Jill and Carlos again. Poor Mikhail didn't survive too long. But before he did that, he spent some time going around Raccoon City and checking some boxes on his to-do list. The first thing he did was head into Raccoon General Hospital and wire the place with C4 charges. At the hospital, he also ran into Tyrell Patrick, another Umbrella monitor, though Nikolai would go on to attack and fatally injure him, intending to steal his data for an extra monetary reward. Carlos would soon chance upon Patrick while he was in the hospital, where he was looking for a vaccine for Jill after she was infected by the T-virus in a fateful fight against Nemesis. Before dying, Patrick told Carlos about Nikolai, and he in turn would go on to relay this information to Jill, but we'll get to that in a bit. After the hospital, Nikolai's next destination was the Raccoon University, where he aided a group of UBCS soldiers with something called Operation Emperor's Mushroom, as portrayed in Resident Evil Outbreak. What exactly was this operation? Its primary purpose was to square off against an experimental rogue tyrant called Thanatos over at the university. While a group of soldiers would engage it in combat, Nikolai would use the distraction to extract a sample from it to take it back to HQ. While the group was able to distract Thanatos long enough for Nikolai to plan plant a device for extracting its blood on its back. The plan did not proceed any further. Thanatos proceeded to kill all the UBCS soldiers and escaped promptly afterward, with Nikolai unable to extract the sample. Intent on making up for the monetary compensation he'd lost out on, he instead killed the rogue Umbrella researcher Dr. Greg Mueller, who had not only created Thanatos but had also been working on a vaccine for the T-virus. And of course, Nikolai also blew up the university with C4. His not-so-happy reunion with Jill came shortly afterward. Having done all he could in Raccoon City, Nikolai headed to the Raccoon Park, where Umbrella had been using a cabin as a comm center. Here, he was advised by Umbrella that the US government had decided to wipe Raccoon City off the map with a nuke to contain the T-virus, and that as such, he didn't have long to get out of there. While he's leaving, he runs into Jill, and he sees his chance to do what Nemesis so far has failed to do by killing her, and also collecting a handsome reward from Umbrella in the process. Their encounter is cut short, though, when a mutated monster called the Gravedigger attacks from beneath the ground. While Jill proceeds to engage it in combat, Nikolai flees from the scene, heading to an incineration plant nearby for extraction. Of course, there, he has a final run-in with Jill, but thanks to Resident Evil 3 Nemesis's live selections mechanic, it's one that can go one of several different ways. One of the endings for his character sees him taking Jill on in a fight, before being caught by surprise by Nemesis, who impales him with one of his appendages and kills him. Another ending sees Nikolai getting on board a chopper that Jill had intended to use for her own escape. Here, Jill can either choose to destroy the helicopter and kill him, or try and reason with him. The latter doesn't work out, of course, and ends with Nikolai successfully escaping from Raccoon City. And that's the full story of Nikolai Zinoviev. Much like his fellow UBCS soldier Carlos, we haven't seen or heard much, or anything, of Nikolai since Resident Evil 3. That and Outbreak are the only times he's made an actual substantial appearance in the series. He will be coming back very soon, though, when Resident Evil 3's remake releases on April 3, and we're looking forward to seeing how or if Capcom expands on his character. And that about does it for this video. If you enjoyed what you watched and want to see more from GamingBolt, please hit the subscribe button. Also, don't forget to switch on the notifications bell icon next to it. That way you'll never miss any of our videos. Thanks for watching!